Piper Aircraft is a very unique aircraft manufacturing company. We actually produce over 90% of the aircraft in-house. Piper Aircraft has one facility with roughly 750,000 square feet of manufacturing space. From nose to tail, there's literally thousands of parts that we produce, and many of them come off the Haas machines. Hi, my name is Kevan Chisholm. I'm the new business development manager here at PIMCO and Piper Aircraft. Over the past 3 or 4 years, Piper's invested around $30 million in new infrastructure and capital equipment. What that's done is it created small pockets of large excess capacity. PIMCO was born of the vision of our CEO, John Calcagno. What he's wanting to do is grow the business on the fab side. So we can offer Piper's 85 years of fabrication excellence to our customers. Meaning we can do products for Piper and for whatever our customers' needs are at the same time. So one pallet could be doing Piper, one pallet could be doing a customer, and it would just be streamlined. There would be no break in the process. An example of some of the new unique equipment that Piper's invested in are the two 1250 UMC pallet pull systems that we have. These are going to allow us to run lights out to get excess capacity so we can offer our customers even more time on the machines.
So one of the things we do here at Piper Aircraft when we're talking about machine performance or work center performance, that's what we call the machine centers here at Piper Aircraft, our work centers. And one of the things we look at is backlog, the overall hours associated to the job and all the jobs that are planned to run on that work center, right? All those hours stack up. So some of the machines that we have are 5-axis and 4-axis, but they're the only version, or were the only version of that type of machine in our shop. So a lot of the 5-axis and 4-axis work only went to those two specific machines. Well, with the increase in aircraft demand, backlog has gone up. Those hours associated with those parts, we have to essentially make more of those parts for those aircraft, because we have to make more aircraft. So now those hours go higher. Our plan is with the purchase of the UMCs, is to level load those two machines, the current 5-axis machine we have and the 4-axis machine we have. We want to level load the work on those machines across 4 machines instead of 2 machines. So we essentially bring the 6,000 hours between those two machines and divide that by 4 and spread that work out across 4 machines. And it actually brings the backlog down, helps the productivity go up, and also drives the capacity higher. We can now add more work from outside the plant that we're not making, that we should be making, and bring it back in the plant. The EC500 was proof of concept that more pallets on the machine gives us essentially more utilization of the machine. A lot of our parts and processes that we make in our shop on all of our machines, we're usually making one part at a time, and the quantities are fairly low. If we can increase the utilization by keeping that spindle running longer by using more than one pallet, we can set up one pallet with one job, one pallet with another job, another pallet with another job, schedule those pallets, and now we've turned a overall setup and runtime into an all-day affair instead of just running that job and when I'm done, tearing it down and setting up another one. The machine downtime almost goes away.
Piper has a 10-year relationship with Haas. We're excited to continue that relationship well into the future as PIMCO continues to grow.